Vaya, Bhagavati Uttama Shloke, Bhakti Bhagavati Naishtiki. Escuchando el Srimad Bhagavatam diariamente y sirviendo, and serving under a pure devotee, all that is inauspicious within the heart is practically removed, and loving devotional service to the Supreme Personality of Gaudiya becomes established as an irrevocable effect. So this coming to the class every day is the spiritual essence of our eating. You see, we eat every day. Very rarely that we fast a whole day. Maybe we fast at morning, but the spiritual science of self-realization is based on good food. It's the good food of good classes. It's the good food of spiritual clarity. Where things are made clear to you, so you can have all your questions answered. This is part of what the class is all about. It's not a beautiful get-together, okay, and somebody puts a little bit of his ego of being a good speaker or something like that. No. The class means clarification, therefore. What's right, what's wrong, how to do it. In this platform, the daily platform, where you have a right to question what you do. You have a right in Krishna consciousness in the class to question the status quo. To tell you the truth, that's why I like it. That's why I like Krishna consciousness. I was never interested in any dogmatic process where you just imposed upon under some fear or something like that. I always wanted my intellect to be part of what I'm doing. Now in Bhakti Yoga, I understand the heart is above the intellect, that's okay. We do that, we respect that. Nevertheless, it was exactly when my intellect was not appreciated that I had to find my own way. I couldn't continue under the imposition of some people who cared for everything except for what I was thinking and feeling. That's when the mission was started. Because we needed to have a space for our satisfaction. And this satisfaction is not selfish satisfaction, no. It's for the sake of my own path and clarity, I need to be able to question whether what you're telling me is right or wrong. And then if I believe it and I feel it's right, then I will give my heart to it and I will participate in it. If it's not, if it deviates from my Gurudeva, for example, then I will have to take a distance. I have nothing to do with it. Srila Bhakti Rakakshina Maharaj used to call this society consciousness versus God consciousness. Sometimes we have society consciousness dominating us, but we are not interested in society consciousness. We are interested in God consciousness. What is God's desire? What does He want? How can I act according to it? What is his teaching? What is my relationship with him? How will he connect to me according to what I'm doing? Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita that he will reward me accordingly to how I behave. This will be the criteria. So, questioning and answer, challenging the status quo, challenging anything, but not in a challenging mood. The challenging mood is not very favorable. It should be the inquiry, the sincere inquiry mood, which helps us in our spiritual progress. So we have a great chance of association. A great chance of doing things for Prabhupada. And in the end of the day, you have to go out and be responsible for what you're doing. You can say, my guru, my guru, my guru, that's very nice. But if what you're doing is not good, then your my guru, my guru, my guru is good for nothing. All you do is give a bad image to your guru. So, I'm delighted to participate in this question and answer program every day. That's why I give classes, or I'm involved with the classes for the last 45 years. Every day. And sometimes more than one class. But at least one class in the morning and in the evening. So that there's a chance for everybody to find out what is it what we are practicing. Why should I believe this and why should I practice this? And I appreciate people like Haryana many years in Argentina doing seva. Patti, Berlin, Munich, many years. He's a critical member. He's looking, he's not stupid. As a matter of fact, he was a software engineer of BMW. He can't be too stupid for that. So, smart people should also understand Krishna consciousness. Whether they're so smart that they want to serve the Supreme Lord, that's another question. Many times people are outsmarting themselves. They are so intelligent that they say, yes, everything I'll do the way I want it. There's nobody above me, there's no higher principle, nothing. So, question and answer. Clarifying the path. And it's not an easy path. Raganuga Bhakti, Vaidya Vidhi Bhakti, and there's the how they put it into practice, what Prabhupada did, what Sri Ramaj did, what Bhaktivilas Tirtha Maharaj did, what Bhaktivinay Bhan Maharaj did. You see, each of them did great things in different areas. And we are learning from them. Sometimes we learn what to do and sometimes we also learn what not to do. And now in our South American Vrinda mission, we have the Gurudeva Tulananda example. Always chanting, always enthusiastic. So, and then we have the many sannyasis.
Jago, Jago, Jago.
Hey, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Poland La Yatra Kija.
So this is the real criteria of a spiritual process, a process where your individualization is taken into consideration, is appreciated. Even more than that, it's required. We cannot do without it. The future of Krishna consciousness is with you and is within you. And if you don't understand anything, then you will not do anything. And if you don't do anything, then what will be happening to Prabhupada's mission? Prabhupada's mission happens, and it depends on our being alive, believing it and practicing it according to our best capacity. And in this way we can proceed. What will be next? Who knows? We never know what's next. Yesterday we had a nice preaching going on in Puerto Rico. Nice farm, everything. And then, next day, there's no more Puerto Rico, practically. At least nobody can live there now. It's very difficult. No food, no electricity, no nothing. Food is probably the first thing which survives, because they got so many fruit trees there. But then you have to be ready to eat fruits. And we had in Puerto Rico a farm, the Vrindavan farm. We have the temple right next to the Nishinadev cave. And Vaishnava is preaching in the northern part of the island. And the whole island was battered to pieces. Something difficult to imagine. How a storm can devastate a place. A huge island, which is like a country, you know? And that is that Florida was saved by a few inches. So what I'm saying, that everything, every day, things are new. You don't know what's going to be the next, what's the trial. But our life is the same. We will preach, even in Puerto Rico, whether we are rich or poor, whether we have a, whatever we are, we still go on. Because that's our life. Like we're preaching in Cuba, there's no money, there's nothing, the people, they... It's unbelievable. Venezuelans are leaving Venezuela by the thousands, maybe 20,000 Venezuelans daily are leaving Venezuela because there's no food. And we enter Venezuela and open a big temple. Gurudeva Tulananda, myself, we just came from Caracas, Venezuela, where we installed Radha Vinoda. So, who can tell this? What is Krishna's plans? It's very difficult to tell. But we see Krishna's hands is everywhere. And if Krishna has to smash Puerto Rico, then that was something. You know, for the sinfulness of the people today is how they deal with the animals. Any chastisement they will get as nothing, just a little bit. Not many people died in Puerto Rico. Not like when the earthquake hit Haiti. In overnight, 40,000 people were dead. The entire city crumbled on top of everybody. So, natural calamity, all the work we have to do, and Prabhupada is the messenger of love. That's it. Prabhupada is the messenger of love. He is teaching us to have criteria of our own. Srila Prabhupada made us Brahmins. Brahmins are self-intelligent, self-convinced people of what they are doing. We don't need mindless robots. Or like they call them, yes men. Whatever you say, they say yes. I mean, it's very practical when you are in a temple president position and you have a few yes men. It's not a bad idea. At least somebody does what has to be done. But really, in Krishna consciousness, we don't need the yes man. We need the... put the highest ideal into reality, man. That's what we need. That is what Prabhupada brought us. He made a school for Brahmins. And not for Brahmins as an institution. For Brahmins in its essence. And that essence, the essence which Prabhupada gave to us, that essence is our life and soul. That's what we discuss every day. I can read any shloka. All the shlokas are full of nectar. I can read from anywhere. Immediately there's another spiritual charge, a spiritual responsibility. Each shloka empowers. You want to be empowered? Then listen. I just opened this verse. Brahmadayo bahutitam yat apanga moksha kamastapa samacharam bhagavat prapanna sa shri svavasham aravindavanam vihaya yat pada shobhagam malam bhajate nurakta tasyaham abhya kulishankusha ketu ketai Srimad Padair Bhagavata Samalang Kritangi Trin Atyorocha Upalapya Tato Vibhutim Lokam Samam Vyashrach Utsmayatim Tapante. Lakshmiji, the goddess of fortune, whose glance of grace was sought by the demigods like Brahma, and for whom they surrendered many a day unto the Supreme Personality of Godhead, gave up her own abode in the forest of lotus flowers, engaged herself in the service of the lotus feet of the Lord. I was endowed with specific powers to supersede the fortune of all the three planetary systems by being decorated with the impressions of the flag, thunderbolt, elephant driving rod, and lotus flower, which are signs of the lotus feet of the Lord. But at the end, when I felt I was so fortunate, the Lord left me. That's a tough one. That's a real tough one. What's in Prabhupada? The beauty and opulence of the world can be enhanced by the grace of the Lord and not by any man-made planet. When the Lord Sri Krishna was present on this earth, the impressions of his special signs of his lotus feet were stamped on the dust, and as a result of the special grace, the whole world was made as perfect as possible. In other words, the rivers, the seas, the forests, the hills, and the mines, which are the supplying agents for the necessity of man and animals, were fully discharging their respective duties. Therefore, the riches of the world surpassed all the riches of other planets in other three planetary systems of the universe. One should therefore ask, that the grace of the Lord always be present on earth, so that we may be favored with his causeless mercy and be happy, having all necessities of life. One may ask how we can detain the Supreme Lord on this earth after his mission is fulfilled and he has left the earth for his own abode. The answer is that there is no need to detain the Lord. The Lord, being omnipresent, can be present with us if we want him at all. By his omnipresence, he can always be with us if we are attached to his devotional service by hearing, chanting, remembering, etc. There's nothing in the world with which the Lord is disconnected. The only thing we must learn is to excavate the source of connection and thus be linked with him by offenseless service. We can be connected with him by the transcendental sound, representation of the Lord. The holy name of the Lord and the Lord himself are identical, and one who chants the holy name of the Lord is an offense in an offenseless manner, can at once realize that the Lord is present before him. Even by the vibration of ratio sound, we can partially realize sound relativity, and by resounding the sound of transcendence, we can verily feel the presence of the Lord. In the age when everything is polluted by the contamination of Kali, it is instructed in the scriptures and preached by Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that by chanting the holy name of the Lord, we can be at once be freed from contamination and gradually rise to the status of transcendence and go back to Godhead. The offenseless chant of the holy name of the Lord is as auspicious as the Lord himself, and the movement of pure devotees of the Lord all over the world can at once change the troublesome face of the Lord. Only by the propagation of the chanting of the holy names of the Lord can we be immune from all effects of the age of Kali. This is incredible. The empowerment coming from these shlokas. They include the empowerment to chant the holy names. That's why everywhere it's repeated. Always chant the holy name of the Lord. Make him present before you. That is the message of Prabhupada. By talking about Krishna, by thinking about Krishna, by doing everything in connection with Krishna. This is the simple message which we have received and which we should practice and put into practice every day. Nashta prayeshu abhadrishu nityam bhagavata sevaya bhagavati uttama shloki bhakti bhavati naishti. Always glorify Krishna's holy name. Always chant the holy Bhagavatam. Always serve the pure devotees of the Lord. You will be successful. You will be advancing rapidly. You will be empowered. So my question was this. Will you be empowered by this shloka of today? There's much more than one shloka. That was Prabhupada's problem. There was a whole empowerment that how we can be in connection with the Lord by simply offenselessly invoking his presence. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. That is the essence. Any question? Now it's up to you to exercise what I just said. Making a good use of your intellectual faculty so that you can confirm what has been said to make it really go deep inside of you, or question it so that you will get more details on it. You see, this is basically it. Krishna consciousness is the path of clarity.
where we will learn how to do things in an appropriate way. Any question? None, and believe it. You're so intellectual and so sweet and so submissive and so wonderful. And you say, oh, it's okay. No question. But actually, we are supposed to have tons of questions. Questions about how to put the ideal into practice. Question about the matter and spirit. How is matter manifesting spirit? How is spirit above matter and still transmits its presence through matter? You have a question, Marta. I would call it the divine universal love principle. That's basically it. If we have the universal love principle alive, then all the other things come in secondary as beautiful things, additional. What can you do for the universal love principle? Well, it's not so difficult. Just don't get on anybody's case. Be kind to everybody, help others according to your ability, and make people feel that you're happy that they exist. That's in itself is quite an accomplishment. Of course, universal love principle, it also implies Sarve Bhavantu Sukhina, Sarve Shantu Nilamaya, Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu, Makachintu Kabak Bhavit. It also means you want them, people should be healthy, people should be with their own power of discrimination, people should be not in misery under anybody's fault, much less under mine. And I should work always for the world peace. Om Shanti, Om Shanti, Om Shanti. And what does it mean, working for the world peace? That means Om, the truth. That is the basic key ingredient for peace. If we want to live a life of peace, we have to be connected to the Om. The Om is everything. Om Shanti is not sentiment. Om Shanti is the principle of a divine connection. Any other question? Yes, my dear. Cuestionar el status quo con tu corazón y con tu inquietud. Cuando tú estás desubicado o triste con el status quo, entonces cuestiona el status quo. Porque para qué sigue un status quo que solamente produce frustraciones para ti. Entonces estás autocondenándote en ser una persona mediocre. Como le digo, eso no es una cuestión de challenging. It's more a question of wanting to satisfy what's my inner heart's demand. Just like when you're an environmental lawyer, then you're sitting in the office, and then all of a sudden you see that the environment is being abused very severely. You think, what am I going to do about that? And then you find out that the people behind the abuse to the environment, they're all your bosses. They're all the higher-ups in the justice system and so on. And then you feel, oh, this is a real frustration. I don't want to be part of this. So it's an example that the status quo not only has to be questioned, it has to be rejected. Then you can become yourself and be happy. Yes, my dear Marta.
How is the right way of providing one's obligation or responsibility with family and friends when at the same time you have a very strong need of being away and studying and doing things that somehow moves you away from?
The last part I didn't understand.
Everyone has a responsibility with his family and friends.
Yes.
You need your love and you need to be for them. But how do you combine that when you have a very strong need to be on your own, to study, to be inside, to do things that somehow moves you away from your family? How do you do that? There's always some guilt in that. But at the same time, you really have that need to move and do things.
That's a very interesting question. And it requires adhikar. Adhikar means spiritual realization. There's distinct criteria. And there is no straight hard and fast answer. I may be defending my family from my heart, but I'm going in the jungle to become a guerrilla fighter because the country is abusing everybody and creating a no future situation. Exactly. So my family said, why you go in the jungle? You should come out and make some money here. But my call is for this. I have to free my country from the oppression. So you can decide that. But when it comes to spiritual topics, it's more easy. It's not that complicated. Because generally, those who live spiritual life, they're very responsible with their families. They're always looking that the family has what they need, on one side. On the other side, they can also understand that there's priorities, and the priority is not home comfort, but it is the priority is that our ideals are being attended properly. It's a higher principle. And that's where yoga is very helpful. With the practice of yoga, we get a good idea what to do and how to harmonize with all these things, food issues. Like sometimes in the family, we have food issues. Some people don't want to be vegetarian or things like that. But every issue which is there, there's always a solution. Spiritual life is, Srila Guru Maharaj, my spiritual teacher, said, Krishna consciousness is the harmonizing agency. It always harmonizes everything. But it doesn't always mean that everybody's happy. Sometimes people don't understand. When I joined Krishna consciousness, my parents, my father in particular, couldn't understand whatsoever what was up to my mind. But when I was older, he recognized that I did the right thing. That was 40 years later. So, it's good. Some things need to be understood over a long period. A little bit like Jesus said, I didn't come to bring peace and harmony. I brought the fight over the truth right into the family. Well, I think this is enough for today. Thank you very much for listening to my appreciation of Srila Prabhupada and his Dashta Prayeshua Padrishu principle, which I have lived by and I want to keep living by it, because it really makes life good. Otherwise, who would get up in the morning to sit down for 1 hour? Who's doing that in the material world? Nobody goes anywhere to listen to the class. Only when you're at the school, then you have to. Hare Krishna.
Wir kaufen, ja.